Right, is that a curse drop? And have a look at that incantation if we can. So you can shriek and build up madness. An incantation originating from the maddening three fingers. Three fingers, not two, you'll notice. Jabriri was the most reviled man in all history. So the plot thickens. The finger count increases. Right, so this is a safe spot. Relatively speaking. And then we can roll across here and hopefully get up this first ladder. Right, so yeah, any time our eyeballs are glowing, we're in trouble. And we've got three of them, but there's six of them. Fucking hell. Do we have to kill all six to get rid of this? Or is this just something we have to live with around here? I don't know. Right, quick bit of research tells me that we need to kill them all to stop this bollocks from happening. And we can't really explore without doing that, so... yeah. That's the next plan. But even just being in it for a second drains your HP. It's a very Bloodborne mechanic. Which is to say, it's fucking horrible and it sucks. Like, much of Bloodborne. And I mean that in the kindest way to Bloodborne. But a lot of it does suck. We got him. Ah, thank goodness for that. Right. I wonder if there's a sensible way to pick them off from range, but... yeah, Lulu doesn't have a bow, so... the main thing is, they're dead. The rats down below shouldn't be too much of an issue anymore, because we can just run away from the buggers. The fact you can mount your horse in there is nice. And now we should just probably be careful with the Frenzy Flame Village, because, yeah, otherwise we'll just insta-get killed. So yeah, ignore the fact that they're all just standing around, because they are going to aggro at some point. Ruin our day. Yep. Nice. Yeah, Flame Sling still appears to be our best fireball throwing spell right now. And it's pretty darn good. We should probably be using it more. Alright, so we've got some knights over there. We've got the Frenzied Cookbook. So I guess that's used for making frenzy-related gubbins. Note, the Lord of Frenzied Flame. Okay, I guess this will be like, yep, kill everyone at the tower. Oh no, beneath Leyendell at the very bottom lies our Lord, the Lord of the Frenzied, the Three Fingers who holds us in thrall. Good to know. But oh, Leyendell. Luna is a creature of madness, so maybe we'll have to pay the Three Fingers a visit at some point. Now, what have you lot got to say about anything? Are you all just chilling? You're like right next to a village full of mentalists with flames spewing out their eyes. And you lot are just like, yeah, yeah, it's cool. Weirdos. Oh no, you're also frenzied. Makes a bit more sense now, I guess. Ah, but you've still also got your awful glintstone throwing devices. So you are frenzied carrion knights by the look of it, and I can't lock onto you, it seems. There we go. And then we stop locking on again for no clear reason. Which was a bit silly, made that a bit annoying. Yep, let's throw our magic at each other. Mine's better. Although that spell does look pretty cool. Shabriri's Woe? Is that what, a talisman or is that a headpiece? Might be a talisman from the sound of it. Constantly attracts enemies' aggression. Disturbing likeness of a man whose eyes have been gouged out. Shabriri had his eyes gouged out as punishment for the crime of slander, and with time the blight of the flame of frenzy came to dwell in the empty sockets. Well, don't gouge people's eyes out then, fuck's sake. It's not cool. We've got a church over here. They're always fun. And you. Lord Vyke, it seems you are no lord after all. Then where is he, our true lord, our lord of frenzied flame? Incinerate all that divides and distinguishes, and may chaos take the world. So there you go, you see, they like chaos around here. Now, what we've got in this corner? Anything? Nope. Good to know. Oh god. We're getting invaded. But from where? From him. And... oh, Jesus Christ. That's a hit. Oh, fuck. Drink. Maybe a bit more rotten breath, because that doesn't seem to have rotted him last time. Yeah, he seems to be immune to rot, which means we're in trouble. Oh fuck, especially if he's going to do that much damage with a couple of hits. And we've put away our weapon. That's not great. So we'll keep away, let the madness subside. And then just waltz into an attack. Jeez, this fight's not going well. It's not going badly. Ouch. Ah, fuck you. But yeah, it could definitely be going better. It's too agile. And we're out of flask. Yeah, we don't want any of that. Ah, we got him. Good. We got Vyke's war spear and a fingerprint grape. So this is the eyeball of Knight Vyke. Seared with a repulsive fingerprint burn. Akin to those that marred his entire body, apparently. Offered to the blind maiden, it will lead her to the source of the distant light, allowing her to become a finger maiden. Cool. We need a finger maiden. Now, Vyke's war spear. Frenzy flame thrust. I guess we saw what that was. Causes madness buildup. Strength, dex, and faith. I haven't really got the stats for it. So that's fine. Because you'd probably also want arcane, because you'd want to be able to, you know, actually build up the effect. So a sight of grace here, thank goodness for that. And there's a dead maiden? The finger maiden fillet. And robe, and shoes. Ah! And now we've also got a cloth covered in blood. And a sacred tear. Well, this place is just a winner all round. So now we just need to find Hayata and give her that eyeball, I think. And then we can stop worrying about her quest for a bit. Where might she be? Is it this church she goes to? She goes to a church, I think. Let's have a poke around, see if we can't find her anywhere. Suppose it'd be too much to ask for her to shout out or anything like that. I mean, it's possible she's just sacked off the whole quest. She might just be like, yeah, I'm not eating any more eyeballs. That's ludicrous. Or it's equally possible I'm looking in the wrong place. Yep, she is apparently found in Bellum Church, says my brief research once again. If research is not too strong a word for just having Fextra Life open on my phone. Oh, Jesus Christ, where did you come from? I just heard some frantic footsteps running in and then bam, stabbed. That's what happens when you try and stop and think for like 2 seconds. Because some people are saying that this quest is bugged. Shock. A bugged quest in a FromSoft game. Who'd have thought it? So I'm not actually sure where I should be looking for it. So it's the old FromSoft question. Am I doing it wrong? Or is it just broken? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Lame. Is that it? Have we found it already? Sweet. Now it's a case of let's get out of here. I think a message just popped up there that something exciting has happened. But we're too busy fleeing to worry about that for the moment. Lovely. The 8 braziers have been lit. This is progress towards something or other. I mean, it's a FromSoft game, so it's progress towards a boss fight, I assume. Let's go see what we can do with the old glovewort that we've picked up. Roderick will be delighted to see them, I'm sure. We haven't got any Grave Glovewort 1, that's part of the problem. What the heck? We've got Ghost 1, Ghost 4, Ghost 5, and 0 Grave ones. Shouldn't be a big job. I mean, there's probably a glovewort bell bearing vendor somewhere. Like there is for smithing stones. But I'll be danged if I know where. I'll have to do some research. And in the meantime, I'm pretty sure there's Death Touch catacombs around here somewhere. Somewhere along that road, maybe? So we're going entirely the wrong direction. pretty sure 6 flasks will be enough for the boss. A half-dead Black Knight assassin. Yeah, we should be fine. Go on, lads. Sort him out. Or her. Oh. Just quick. But you can be quick or you can be dead. But on this occasion, she's going to be both. The old crimson dagger. And the death root. Om nom nom. Alright, so what's that given us? Plenty of grave ones. No grave twos, though. So maybe we bob off and do another catacomb somewhere. I mean, the one down there is kind of alright, isn't it? The old impalers. Yeah, so we'd already bounced up here before, but we didn't get the pockmarks, the crater pocks glade site of grace. Fair enough. And we ignored the tower because we know it's just memory stones and they're not for us. Alright, see how two honking great swords get on against boglins. Pretty well. At least against these feeble boglins in a nice easy catacombs. Whoop. Oh, jeez. Yeah, boglins are always a nightmare for the same reason that blood loss is so powerful against bosses. It just doesn't matter how strong you are. Percentage-based damage is mean. Bog off. There we go. Grave 2. Nice. And now we go for a jog. We snag some loots. If we ever get a ghost one that we can use with our low FP, that'll be cool. I guess there's always the mimic tier. That's always an option for everyone, with its cost being get off. Its cost being HP rather than FP. But we were ways away from that yet, so nothing to worry about there. There's a lot of grave ones in here. Thought it might just be twos and threes, but I guess not. Oh, is there a lad around that corner? Yes, there is. I actually remembered for once. And yeah, I'm going to heal. I'd rather have all my flasks intact. Not going to be as cocky as I was with the last fight. Son of a gun. Always seems to get us, that lad. Alright, let's get some wolf friends to distract the enemies, because there's too bloody many of them. But that's two down. Good. And at least we're pretty strong in terms of not taking too much damage, apart from bleed. And now we're down to the boss. So, yeah, GG. Oh, it's one-on-one, though. Not that that matters when it's one-on-one. Demi-human ashes, yay! And we've nearly got enough for another level, actually. So mayhap we get another level. And then we level up our things. So yeah, that's old wolf friend up to level 2. And we'll get jellyfish up to level 2 as well. Because they just seem to be a good suite of spirit ashes for most encounters. You got your agile single one that can wear things down with its poison. And then you've got your pack of dudes that are pretty survivable and agile. Agility seems to be the key with spirit ashes. Basically, is the gist of my presentation here. Now we need smithing 3 to level up both of our swords a bit more. What do we need to level up our bonk hammer? Yeah, smithing 3. So maybe we'll do some mine diving at some point.